Okay, thank you again for joining us. And again, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers who are out there, and happy Mother's Day to all of us. There's ways that we all tap into that mother energy and help bring forth life and nurturing to the world. So we can all take part in Mother's Day, and we can send light and love to all the mothers out there and include ourselves in it. So the title of my talk today, SAFE, the new four-letter word. Okay, so before 9/11, before the terrorist attacks that happened on 9/11, September 11, 2001, if I was going on a trip, if I was going on a vacation, people would say, have a great trip, or have a fun trip. But then 9/11 happened, and immediately that all changed. And everybody just started saying, have a safe trip. And still, that's pretty much what everybody says. Anytime you're getting ready to go on a vacation or a trip of any kind, is have a safe trip. And the overriding communication here is that travel is somehow dangerous and that you have to be on guard and you have to be protecting your safety. So I just noticed that. And I've talked about this before. And for me, this flies in the face of the A Course in Miracles teaching, which says, I am in danger nowhere in the world. So we're supposed to be affirming our infinite, eternal safety and wholeness and immortality and infinite life. We're not supposed to be thinking about the world being this dangerous place that we have to be careful around. And I miss getting wished, have a good trip or have a fun trip. You know, I that was a good energy. I like that good energy. Have a safe trip just doesn't do it for me. You know, A Course in Miracles says, your mission is very simple. You have been chosen to live so as to demonstrate that you are not an ego. I repeat that I do not choose God's channels wrongly. So we're supposed to be living as a living, walking witness demonstration that we're infinite and that we're the holy child of God, that we're not separate, vulnerable, mortal bodies and egos. And that's a challenge, and it's a challenge for all of us in the Course in Miracles community, and it's a challenge for spiritual people everywhere. And it's especially a challenge for us right now, considering the current situation with the so-called coronavirus pandemic. Okay, so before this current situation, when you met somebody, you said hello, and then when you parted, you said goodbye. And you know, the interesting thing is just, you know, the origin of the phrase goodbye is God be with ye. That's where goodbye comes from, God be with ye. Over the years, it got abbreviated, God sort of morphed into good. But when we say goodbye, we're really acknowledging God be with ye. And I think that's a really nice blessing. And nowadays though, instead of saying goodbye, we say stay safe, be safe. And I see the same thing happening again. It's just this idea that we keep reinforcing, that we keep communicating people that the world is dangerous. Before it was travel that became dangerous, and now, God, the whole world is just this dangerous place. Be safe. You know, everybody is saying that. And you know what I remember is, you know, there's never any real safety in the world. I mean, safety isn't in the world. Nothing we do is safe. It's a risk every time I walk outside the door. It's a risk every time I walk down the street. It's a risk every time I get in the car. Actually, it's a risk staying in my house. The house could burn down. You know, anything is likely to happen anywhere. There's no actual way to be safe in the world. Everything is a risk. It's all about risk evaluation. And that I realized, though, this week that when we tell people to be safe, we're actually cursing them. We're cursing them by telling them and reinforcing the philosophy that you live in a dangerous world that's out to get you, and you're a victim of that, and you better be careful. So be safe, be careful, because the world is scary. And I don't want to curse anybody with that idea. And I am challenging people everywhere to just be aware of that and think about what you're saying to people. And I know you'll probably say, I don't mean it that way. Well, that's what gets communicated, at least when I hear it, this idea that living has just now, in and of itself, become so risky that we have to be hyper-vigilant 24/7 about everything. You know, where's the time for some joy and fun and celebration if I'm being so hyper-vigilant about my bodily safety every time? I would really prefer that people just said goodbye. At least that meant God be with ye. And I like that. I'm going with God, but be safe. Safe is our new four-letter curse word. Now, when I give, lately I've been talking about these things, I've been posting a lot of things on my Facebook page. You know, people sometimes think that I am really talking about behaviors, and I'm trying to get people to do unsafe behaviors. And that's not really the truth. The truth is I'm just trying to advocate for people to think about what they're communicating and what thought system they're reinforcing. We're all going to do whatever we're guided to do by the Holy Spirit. If we're guided to stay indoors, we're going to stay indoors. If we're guided to go out and wear a mask, we're going to wear a mask. If we're guided to wash our hands a lot, we're going to wash our hands. We're going to do whatever we're guided to do. And I understand that. And I wouldn't want anybody to do what they weren't guided to do. But what I'm asking people to challenge is just their conversation. How are they talking? How are they speaking? What are they putting out there to the world? I'm advocating for our divine thinking and letting go of our egoic thinking of danger. Now, A Course in Miracles does have some words about safety. It says, God is your safety in every situation. His voice speaks for him in all situations and in every aspect of all situations, telling you exactly what to do to call upon his strength and your protection. So we should be remembering God. That's why saying God be with you is a great thing. Remember that God's always with us. That's our safety. That's what's going to keep us in joy. In another place it says, your safety lies in truth and not in lies. Love is your safety. Fear does not exist. Identify with love and you are safe. You know, that's another thing we could tell people when we part. We could say, I love you, and my love's always with you. We could say something like that, and they could feel the love, and their thought system could go to the love instead of thinking about the danger. What surface can I touch? When was the last time that was sanitized? You know, I'm not for reinforcing that thought system. Again, sanitize whatever counters you want to sanitize. But what kind of thought and what kind of conversation are you giving to the world? You know, in a certain ways, I mean, I believe we curse people when we say be safe. It's like giving them the evil eye. It's like telling them it's dangerous. You better accept the danger. Is that really what we want to be telling people? You know, Ken Wapnick used to say something that I remember. And it's actually kind of unusual for me to be quoting Ken Wapnick, but he would always say, you got to remember there is no world. You know, he was real, real strong on that. And that's certainly something to his credit. There is no world. There is no world. There is no world for us to be safe in, but there is thinking. There is thinking that provides our safety. And the thinking that will provide our safety is to know that God goes with us and that God is with us and that love goes with us and that love surrounds us. And that's what's going to keep us in joy. And that's what's going to keep us safe. Course in Miracles says, there is no world apart from what you wish. And herein lies your ultimate release. Change but your mind about what you want to see, and all the world must change accordingly. So there is no world out there. The world comes from within. And so what thought system we're reinforcing is so vitally important. It's not inconsequential what we say to people. It's not inconsequential the energy that we put out there and the reality that we want to reinforce. I want to reinforce the reality that says divine protection, eternal life, God goes with me wherever I go. I am in danger nowhere in the world. Because that's the world I want to see. And that's the world I want to manifest. And that starts with me. And that starts with my thinking. Ask yourself this. This is another quote from the Course. Can you protect the mind? The body, yes, a little. Not from time, but temporarily. And much you think you save, you hurt. So we think we're providing and doing these things that are keeping us safe. And all it's really doing maybe is keeping the body safe a little bit. Not forever, just for a little while. But and what it says is, and much you think you save, you actually hurt. I mean, we actually don't even understand most of the defenses that we do and the downside that most of them have. Of Course in Miracles says, it is essential to realize that all defenses do what they would defend. The underlying basis for their effectiveness is that they offer you what they defend. What they defend is placed in them for safekeeping, and as they operate, they bring it to you. So defenses, if they're egoically motivated, are just reinforcing the idea of danger, and that idea will manifest. You know, I saw an article on CNN. You know, sometimes people have criticized me that I'm pulling articles from the right-wing conspiratory channels, but this one is from CNN, which is kind of as left-wing as you can get. And it just came out 2 days ago. It was on May 8th. And there's a public health group called the Well-Being Trust. And the Well-Being Trust predicted that if things keep going the way they're going, 75,000 people will die because of suicide and drug overdose, because of what's going on in our society right now. So the defense of sheltering in place, which, you know, sounds good on the surface, seems to make sense, it has a downside. Just like A Course in Miracles says, all defenses accomplish exactly what they would defend against. And the downside is that depression goes up, suicide goes up, drug abuse goes up. And they were predicting 75,000 deaths, and this was based on, you know, statistics from other times when we've had severe economic downturns and things that they could relate. And that's just about as many people as they predict are going to pass from the coronavirus. So, yeah, we're protecting our bodies, maybe, but just like the quotation said, much of what we think we save, we actually hurt, because all those defenses accomplish exactly what they would defend against. Another quotation, the ego dictates endless prescriptions for avoiding catastrophic outcomes. So, you know, we got these endless prescriptions of things we need to do that will somehow save us. You know, obsessive hand washing. Do people really think hand washing is going to save them? I guess some people do. I'm pretty skeptical. I'm washing my hands a lot more, but do I really think, you know, that is going to save me? And the masks. Okay, I got to wear a mask. I can't go into a store in San Francisco and no public place and I don't have a mask on, so I definitely will have a mask on. But do I really think a mask is going to save me from anything? For one, we can't get a consistent, unified story about the masks from anybody. I just saw a video from Anthony Fauci. We all know who he is now, you know, head of the coronavirus task force. And this was just from 3 days ago, May 6th, and he said people should not be walking around wearing masks. He said people should not be walking around wearing masks. That's Anthony Fauci, who I'm not particularly fond of. And he has, you know, a very conservative view on everything. And even he is saying we shouldn't be walking around with masks on. That people who wear masks have a tendency to have a false sense of security. And so they go into places and do things that they probably wouldn't otherwise. Also, people who have masks on tend to touch their face a lot, putting the mask on and off and on and off, and it irritates them and they touch their face a lot. And he says it's the touching of the face that is likely to spread the virus. So, you know, he thinks wearing masks is actually counterproductive. The Surgeon General of the United States, Dr. Jerome Adams, has also flip-flopped on wearing masks a couple of times now. Can't seem to make up his mind whether it's a good thing or not. And, you know, I also wonder why the Surgeon General of the United States is not on the coronavirus task force. That seems a little odd. But anyway, he is, it seems like sometimes he says wearing a mask is good. Sometimes he says, you hear different things from different people. I will definitely do it because, you know, the law says I will. And again, it's not really about behavior. It seems like I'm talking about behavior, but I'm really talking about is our thinking. These things are not actually going to help us. They're the endless prescriptions that the ego gives us for avoiding catastrophic outcomes. And we're obsessed with this idea of safety. We're so obsessed with the idea of safety, we don't have any fun anymore. After 9/11, Department of Homeland Security created the Transportation Security Administration, TSA. And the TSA is what checks you when you go into an airport and makes you go through the gate. And this whole industry, you know, this huge industry, I looked it up this morning, and the TSA currently employs 47,000 people. 47,000. So a whole industry has been created out of our fear and out of this illusion of keeping us safe. And once that industry gets created, you know, it never backs down. You know, 9/11 was 19 years ago. We still have TSA, of course. Some people say, well, that's prevented more. Okay, but we still have TSA. But more importantly, the thinking. People are still telling me, have a safe trip every time I get ready. That didn't fade, you know, or a year or two after 9/11. I thought it was going to fade and people would go back to telling me, have a great trip or have a fun trip. No, we still tell people to have a safe trip. Nobody says have fun anymore. Nobody says, you know, yeah, Reverend Linda says, she's not, nobody says have a great trip, have a great time. Everybody tells you to be safe. And of course, A Miracle says the Holy Spirit is the spirit of joy. It doesn't say the Holy Spirit is the spirit of safety. It says the Holy Spirit is the spirit of joy. If we follow the Holy Spirit's guidance, we should be happy. You know, Reverend Peter gave a talk a couple of weeks ago, and he talked about one of the characteristics of studying with Community Miracle Center is we study these profound ideas, but we have a strong emphasis on laughter and staying happy. Another thing, of course, A Miracle says is, why are you not rejoicing? You are free of pain and sickness, misery and loss. Why are we not rejoicing? Why don't we tell people that? Rejoice. You know, we could say goodbye, God be with you, and say, rejoice, have a lot of joyful, exuberant celebrations, and tell me about them the next time I see you. Bless them with that instead of cursing them with the idea that the world is a dangerous place that we have to be careful. The documentary filmmaker, Michael Moore, in his award-winning documentary, Bowling for Columbine. And in Bowling for Columbine, he talks, there's this animated part, where he talks about the American culture's obsession with fear. We're just obsessed with fear. We have become a very, very fearful culture. And we wonder why this all happened. Well, it all happened because it triggered our fears. One of the things that, that surprised me a little bit about the whole pandemic and the whole reaction to it and everything is the number of really great, I thought, A Course in Miracles students who have been practicing for many, many years, decades, that reverted right to real fearful discussion. That their discussion stopped being about the love of God and forgiveness and my brothers and sisters who are one with me. And it all became about ways that they needed to keep safe from the virus and the vulnerability that we all have. And I understand it, but I'm challenging people to think about it and think about, is that the message that A Course in Miracles gives to us? But as I said, I understand it because A Course in Miracles tells us you are severely tempted to abandon Holy Spirit at the outside ring of fear, but he would lead you safely through and far beyond. So there's a severe temptation, as soon as fear gets triggered, to just chuck all the spirituality and just think, oh, it's all, it doesn't really apply to me. I'm just not quite there yet. And it's all metaphor anyway. It doesn't really, maybe someday I'll be, but not now. No, now. It's always going to be now. And it's right now here in this situation. Again, not about what you do. Stay home if you want to stay home. Wear a mask if you want to wear a mask. Wash your hands 100 times a day. But what are you thinking and what are you communicating and what are you expressing and what thought system are you reinforcing? A Course in Miracles says, peace, your peace is with me, Father. I am safe. Your peace surrounds me, Father. Where I go, your peace goes there with me. So it's the peace of God that's going to keep us safe. Why aren't we talking about that? Why aren't A Course in Miracles students talking about that? When people are afraid and don't know what they should do, why aren't we saying, just rest in the peace of God. Let the peace of God be your safety. Let the love of God be your protection. Trust in it. It will provide and it will transport you. Not give in to that severe temptation to abandon him at the outside ring of fear. Another thing, A Course in Miracles quote, do you like the world you made, a world of murder and attack through which you thread your timid way through constant dangers, alone and frightening, hoping at most that death will wait a little longer before it overtakes you and you disappear? You made this up. It is a picture of what you think you are, of how you see yourself. See, this virus situation that seems to be so dangerous and we don't know how to navigate, we made it up. That's what A Course in Miracles is teaching us. And that's what somehow we should be demonstrating and witnessing and emulating and talking about it. It's all been manufactured in our consciousness and we can unmanufacture it. And actually, I believe we will unmanufacture it. I mean, I have great faith in people, in my brothers and sisters and the holy children of God that they are. I see that many of them have retreated into fear, but I know it will be temporary. And that they will rise again when they really remember the true safety that God provides, that love provides, that peace provides, that joy provides. You want to be safe? Laugh. Have some joy. Feel some love. Share some love. That will make you safe and that will protect you. So, just think about it. That's all I ever really ask. I know people are going to do whatever they're going to do, but just think about it. And before you say that word, that new four-letter word, safe, is it really that much different than fuck and shit and cock and cunt? It's a four-letter word. It's a profanity. It's a curse. Safe. Be safe. No. Be joyful. Be happy, celebrate, live, love, be in the light, share that. Now, I know we've gotten new habits now, but I tell you, and I will warn you, if any of you tell me, be safe, I'm going to correct you nicely, I hope. Maybe. If you're the 20th person that does it that day, I might not be so nice. But I'm not going to tolerate that curse, and I'm not going to tolerate people talking profanity to me, and it's become a profanity to me. I will not be safe. I will be joyful. I will be happy. I will be celebrating. I will go on trips because I want to have a great, amazing, fun time, not because I want to be safe. So thank you so much. Thank you for listening to this. I really appreciate it. And I love you all. And be joyful.
All this love I feel for you, a cloud in heaven was made for you. I want to heal you, woman, and make you happy. All these words I'd like to say, I can wish and I can pray. I'd like to raise you, woman.